It's the most wonderful time of the year. With the kids jingle belling and everyone telling you be of good cheer. It's the most wonderful time of the year. There'll be parties for hosting, marshmallows for toasting, and caroling out in the snow. There'll be scary ghost stories.
There'll be scary ghost stories.
There'll be scary ghost stories.
Scary ghost stories.
Every seven Christmases, it has to take someone. That's how the story goes. If you said that to me before, I'd have thought you were mad. Just a story. In every small town, there's folklore, nothing more. Something left over from our infancy as a species. A more primitive time when we didn't understand things. Sometimes people just get lost in the woods. It turns out we don't comprehend everything. There are a great many unspoken and unseen things that exist around us. Some of them more than stories for campfires or misbehaving children. It rose from the lake one Christmas Eve, taking women and children with it to the woods. The men fought it but couldn't defeat its strength. Many of the women perished at the hands of the creature. Rather than risk their own lives, the cowardly elders of the village struck a bargain with the dreadful, dreadful thing. Every 7 years it could take one soul from the village at Christmas, provided it left the people in peace and stayed confined to the woods north of the village. It could just be a fantastic story to explain why so many women and children died at Christmas in an especially bad outbreak of disease in the 12th century. A tale used to make the impoverished, sick and poorly feel grateful for what little they had, when existence itself was a brutal struggle. Just be grateful it didn't come for you. Or was it just a story? It was December the 23rd, 7 Christmases ago, when she was taken. Just a walk in the woods, never to be seen again. Another missing persons case, no trace, no sight or sound, no leads. My being at work might have been the only reason I wasn't a suspect. To say I revisited the spot where she was last seen would be an understatement. Every day and every night for the first year, I knew every inch of the ground, every tree, every branch, every stone. If something was disturbed by the native deer, I would notice. Storms came and went. Life moved on for other people. Perhaps the snows that would come in the winter was God's attempt to make this dirty little town look clean and cover the secrets of the past. They say winter is beautiful, yet everything starts to die. Christmases would come and go. For me, no tree, no decorations, no happy Christmas. No explanation, no sight, no sound. Until now. How it came to be here 7 years later. Her necklace, I can't explain. It's not an uncommon piece and had no unique markings or engravings. But I take it as more than coincidence. Does it wish to mock me? Does it know I've wandered these woods for years? The greatest gift of all is giving. I've been preparing for 7 years to give something back. The ultimate gift.
It's the most wonderful time of the year. With the kids jingle belling and everyone telling you be of good cheer. It's the most wonderful time of